Hello student, myself Professor Gada Kesses from S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, Yola. Student, we are learning the final year subject that is nothing but solar and wind energy. Up to the last lecture in the online lecture series, we have seen so many topics from unit number 1 to unit number 4. Now, in the unit number 4, we are seeing from the last lecture the case study related to the solar PV water pumping system. So, in the last lecture, we have discussed what is the solar PV water pumping system, its block diagram, and then we have seen the steps involved in the solar PV water pumping system. So, total five steps we have seen. Related to that, some definitions also we have seen. So, we will don't get any problem while designing the solar PV water pumping system. Now, in the today's lecture, we are already going to see the actual case study related to the solar PV water pumping system. That means in the today's lecture, we are going to design one of the solar PV water pumping system. So let's see. So today's case study is related to the design of solar PV system for pumping 25,000 liter of water every day from depth of 10 meter is considered. That means the today's case study is related to the pumping of 25,000 liter of water per day. We have to lift it from the height or depth of the 10 meters. So let's see how to design the solar PV system for that solar PV water pumping system for that particular requirements. So first you have to calculate the given data. So data required for the calculation and steps of calculations are. So some steps are given for the calculations. So first step is amount of water to be pumped per day. So in the case study, which amount of water we have taken? 25,000 of water, 25,000 liter of water per day. So 25,000 liter of water we have taken. That means 25 meter cube of water we have to lift per day. So the total vertical lift, that means what? How much height we have to lift the water. So total vertical lift is equals to 12 meter. So how 12 meters? Why 12 meters? We have taken the depth 10 meters, but here total vertical lift is 2 meter. Why? That they have given in the bracket. So 5 meter elevation, then 5 meter standing water level, that means water level is there, and for 2 meter drawdown is there. That means total 12 meters we have to vertical lift. Okay, all of you understand? Then next step is related to the water density. So what is the density of water? That all of you know, 1000 kg per meter cube. Then acceleration due to gravity, that means value of the small g, that we should know, 9.81 meter per second square, 9.8 meter per second square. Then solar PV module used. Now here we have to decide which solar PV module we are going to use. So the size of solar PV module we have considered here, that is nothing but 75 WP. Okay, so watt of power. Now operating factor. So what is the operating factors? Operating factor is nothing but 0.75 for the 75 watts power of the solar PV module. So PV panel mostly does not operate at peak rated power. Then pump efficiency. So the pump which we have used, for that we have to consider the pump efficiency. Generally we are considering the pump efficiency near around 30%. So 30% means 0.3 and can be between 0.25 to 0.40. okay, that means 25 to 40% in between. So we are considering here pump efficiency 30%. So mismatch factor also we have to consider. So how much mismatch factor we have taken? 0.85. So PV panel does not operate at maximum power point. That's why mismatch factor we have taken 0.85. So that's are the data which we require to design the actual solar PV water pumping system. So let's start the calculation for designing the solar PV water pumping system. So step first, determine the total daily water requirement. Daily water requirement we have already calculated, that is nothing but 25 meter cube per day. Second step we have seen in the last lecture also. Second step is that determining the total dynamic head, that is the TDH. So in the total dynamic head, how many quantities are available? That is vertical lift plus frictional losses. So vertical lift we have calculated, that is nothing but the 12 meters, and frictional loss is nothing but 5% of total vertical lift. So 5% into total vertical lift is 12. So 0.05 into 12 is nothing but 0.6 meter. So total dynamic head is nothing but total vertical lift, that is 12 meter, plus frictional losses, that is 0.6 meter. So total dynamic head, that is TDH, is nothing but 12.6 meter. All of you understand? So that we have calculated step number 2. Now step number 3 is related to the determine the hydraulic energy required per day. So hydraulic energy required to raise the water level is nothing but, how to calculate hydraulic energy? MGH. So M is mass of the water, how much you have to lift. G is acceleration due to gravity, and TDH is nothing but the total discharge head, total dynamic head. So mass, here mass of the water is not given, but we know density is equal to mass per unit volume. So mass we can calculate by the density into the volume, into G into TDH. So density of water we know 1000 kg per meter cube. Volume of the water we know that we have to lift per day, that is 25 meter cube per day. G is acceleration due to gravity, that is 9.81, and into TDH, that is total dynamic head. Total dynamic head is nothing but 12.06 or 12.6. So here we can calculate the dynamic hydraulic energy required, that is nothing but the 857.5 watt hour per day. But here we have multiplied by 1/3600 to convert second into the hours, because here we have taken in the hours, and we have to calculate the total hydraulic energy required into the watt hour per day. So we have multiplied it by 1/3600. So the total hydraulic energy required is nothing but the 857.5 watt hour per day. So one note is given here, the potential energy of water is raised due to the pumping, which must be supplied to the pump. So that is nothing but the step number 3. Now step number 4 is related to the determining solar radiation data. Now how much solar radiation is available, that we have to calculate in the step number 4. So solar radiation data in terms of equivalent peak sunshine radiation, that is 1000 watt per meter square, varies between about 4 to 7 hours. For exact hours, meteorological data should be used. So we are going to take 6 hours per day, that is peak of the 1000 watt per meter square equivalent. The actual day length is longer. This is equivalent to the solar radiation of 180,000 watt hour per month at a given locations. So solar radiation we have taken 6 hours per day. That means 6 hours per day solar energy or solar radiation is available, that we are taking. Now step number 5, that is last step, we are going to determine the number of PV panels and pump size. Number of PV panels and pump size we are going to calculate. So total wattage of the PV panel. So how much wattage of PV panels are required, that we are going to calculate. So here how to calculate total wattage of PV panel is equals to total hydraulic energy divided by, that means total hydraulic energy means the energy required to pump the water, divided by number of hours peak sunshine per day. That means the for number of hours sunshine or for sunlight is available per day, that we are going to see. So total hydraulic energy we have calculated 857.5, and solar radiation we have considered for 6 hours per day. So if we divide it, we will get 142.9 watt. That much solar panels are required, that much capacity of solar panels are required for designing the solar PV water pumping system. Now second, we have to considering system losses also. Now here in the first case we don't consider any losses, but if we consider the system loss, so pumping efficiency into mismatch factor we have to consider. So total PV panel wattage divided by pumping efficiency into the mismatch factor. So pumping efficiency we have taken 30%, into mismatch factor we have taken 85%, so 0.85. so here we will get 560 watt. So 560 watt of the solar panel is required. Considering operating factor for PV panel, so total PV panel wattage after losses divided by operating factor. So total PV panel wattage after losses is 560 watt divided by operating factor 0.75. so here in that case 747.3 watts of solar panel is required. So number of 75 watt solar panel required. So how many 75 watt? One solar panel is of the 75 watt power solar photovoltaic cell is there. So how many total photovoltaic solar PV panels are required, that we will calculate. So maximum amount of energy required developed by the solar panel is 747.3 watt, and one panel will develop 75 watt of the power. So totally 9.96, that means near around 10 solar panels are required of the 75 watt power per day. So operate power rating of the motor is nothing but 747.3 divided by 746, that is nothing but the 1 HP motor is required. So here we have designed the solar PV system. So in that solar PV system we have designed how much power of the electric motor is required, how many total solar panels are required to design the required amount of the water pumping system. So student, we will stop here for the today's lecture, and next point, next case study, we will continue in the next lecture. Thank you friends.